What's up, everyone? Sam Gavis Houston here, and first of all, happy 2020. And second of all, in this video, I'm gonna be showing you exactly how to set your goals for 2020 and for the years beyond for your coding interview prep so that you know exactly what you need to do to land your dream job this year. And if you're interested in more videos just like this on nailing your interview and landing that dream job, make sure you hit the subscribe button and the little bell icon, and you'll get a notification every week when we release new videos. All right, like I said in the introduction, in this video, I want to show you how to start setting goals for your coding interview prep so that you actually know what you're going for, what your goal is, and you have an actual plan for how to achieve it. I find so often that it's really easy to get in this mindset of just doing the thing or sort of having this vague idea of what our goal is without actually really sitting down and defining it clearly and understanding what that should look like. And so in this video, I want to make sure that we're setting clear goals, because the clearer our goal is and the better we define it, the more easier it is for us to actually achieve it and for us to land that dream job. So let's get into it. First, I actually want to talk about three of the most common mistakes that I see when people set goals, because you want to make sure that you're avoiding these mistakes as you're going through this, or it's going to be a lot more difficult for you to actually be successful. So number one, you don't want to choose a goal that is totally out of your control. I see a lot of times where people set goals like, it would be like saying something like, my goal is to win $1 million at the lottery. And that would be a pretty dumb goal, right? Because it's like, that might be something you want, but that's not something that you can actually work towards achieving. And in the same way, I think a lot of times we think about a goal as, I want to land this job at this company, or I want to do this very particular thing. And we just have to realize that the more we can set a goal that is in our control, the better. Because a lot of times if your goal is just like, I want to work at Google, then there's only so much degree to which that's actually in your control at all. Even if you do all the right things, your interview can still go wrong. And so a better goal might be to say, I want to get a job at like a FANG company, or I want to get a job at this set of companies, because that way you're sort of removing that randomness and you are defining something that is similar and it's going to, and you can work towards and is much more like within your control. So that's mistake number one. Mistake number two, and this is a huge one, is choosing a goal based on what you think should be your goal and not what you actually want. And I see this so frequently. Like, I just had a friend recently who took a job at Amazon, and he took that job at Amazon because he felt like that was something that he should do. That was like the best offer that he got, and that was the most prestigious company that he got an offer for. And so he took that even though he didn't think that he was going to be happy there, because he felt obligated to. And this is something that I see so often, and it's so important when you're thinking about your goals, and we will talk about this, that you pick the goal based on what you actually want and what's actually exciting to you, rather than some like expectation from your parents or expectation from your peers or even expectation from yourself. And number three, you have to understand what is the cost of succeeding at your goal. And let me explain this. So a lot of times we say, I want to achieve this or I want to achieve that, and that's great. But what we're not willing to do is we're not actually willing to put in the work to get there. And so it's so important that you understand, when you set a goal, what is the cost of achieving that goal? What are you going to have to sacrifice to achieve that goal? It's like if you want to get really in really good shape, the cost of that is saying, I'm going to eat right. I'm not going to like go out drinking with my friends, and I'm going to go to the gym every day. And if you're not willing to put in that effort, you're not going to achieve that goal. And the same is true with coding interviews. You have to understand what the cost is. So if you want to get a job at a top tech company, that's going to mean that you're going to have to spend explicit time studying. You're going to have to potentially sacrifice other things in your life while you're working on that interview prep process. So you can set whatever goal you want, as long as you understand what the buy-in is, what the cost of achieving that goal is going to be. Now that we've talked about the three common mistakes that people make when they're setting their goals, I want to talk about, how do we actually define a goal? How do we figure out what our goal is and what that goal should be? And then how do we create and structure that goal in a way that is going to be most effective and that we're going to get that result most effectively? So when you're trying to define the goal and figure out what the goal should be, I want to recommend two steps that you follow. First of all, you want to brainstorm ideas, right? You want to get everything out on the table because a lot of times we tend to be very quick to censor ourselves. So I love personally using a whiteboard and just writing everything that comes to mind. What is every possible goal I could have? And then you just basically like do this very broad brainstorm. And then once you have all these things, you're going to be able to say, okay, which of these things are most important to me? Could I combine these into a singular goal? There are lots of different ways that we can then take this and reduce it. And one of the exercises once we do this that I really like is an exercise called the five whys. And so the five whys is an exercise where if I were to say like, hey, my goal is to get a job at Google, then I would ask myself why, right? I'm gonna ask, well, why do I wanna get a job at Google? And then the answer might be, well, because the pay is really good. And then I would ask like, well, why do I want a job where the pay is really good? And then it might be because I want like stability. And then if I say, you know, I want stability, why do I want stability? Well, I want stability because I had this experience in my life where I didn't have stability. You can keep going back and back, but what the five whys allows you to do is it allows you to take this goal that's sort of an obvious thing or a trivial thing, like I want to get a job at Google or I want to get a FANG job, and it allows you to identify the underlying reasons why that goal is actually important to you. And what you can do with that is now you can say, rather than saying I want to get a job at Google, you can say like, okay, well, in this particular example, the thing that's most important to me is job security, right? And so I might say, well, what are different ways that I could achieve that goal? Like maybe I want a government contract job because that's going to afford me the most security. And that's secondary to me compared to like the excitement. And so the five whys is a great way to get started with breaking down the goal and figuring out what is important to you. And once you've done that like broad brainstorm, using the five whys to get really specific about what the underlying motivation is can really help you identify what is going to be the right goal for you. Then once you have that, you want to define your goal in terms of the SMART framework. So it's S-M-A-R-T, which stands for specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time-bounded. And so this is an acronym that basically is a strategy that you can use for defining a goal that is going to be structured in such a way that it is most easy for you to attain. And so I just want to talk through this super briefly. So first of all, we want our goal to be specific, right? We want it to be a specific thing, and specific and measurable kind of go hand in hand. Because what you want is a goal where you can very clearly say, I know what the goal is and I know when I've achieved the goal. If your goal is like, I want to be happy, that's really tough unless you say specifically how you're going to know, right? Like you could say, if your goal is to be happy, you might instead say, I want to have it so that I want to reach the point where I'm an 8 out of 10 on the scale of like least happy to most happy 5 days out of the week. And that would be a very specific measurable thing where you can say, okay, I achieved my goal or I haven't. And so in the same way with the interviews, you might say, well, I want to get a job at X company. And then it's very clear, yes, you achieved the goal or no, you didn't achieve the goal. So that's specific and measurable. And then achievable is really subjective, but that's something where it comes back to what is the cost of achieving this goal? What is the cost of going for this goal? You have to decide, is this goal something that I can actually achieve or is this totally out of reach? Because if you set a goal that's like too far out of reach, then you're never going to achieve it, right? And it's just gonna be frustrating. Like a goal that might be totally out of reach would be, I wanna solve every LeetCode hard problem in less than 30 minutes. That's very, very unlikely. You could potentially get there, but it's gonna be a real struggle and it's gonna be really frustrating to try and get there. So you wanna try and keep a balance. And then you have relevant, which is really, is this goal relevant to you? Do you actually want the goal? And that's why we did the five whys, right? Because you want to make sure that it's a goal that you really want to achieve or else you're not going to be motivated to do it. And then finally, you want time bounded. You want that T where you're going to say, I want to achieve this goal by X date. And so a perfect example of what this might look like in the coding interview space is I want to get a job offer from a FANG company making $150,000 a year by March 31st. And maybe that's realistic, maybe that's not. Maybe that's achievable for you, maybe it's not. But that's just an example of what that goal might look like. And so I want you to take a moment now to actually pause this video and write down like what is going to be your SMART goal. And in the comments below, let us know like what is going to be your SMART goal for the next year. Now, finally, I want to talk about something that's really important here, which is actually sticking to your goal, right? Because I'm sure that we've all done this where we set like a New Year's resolution or we set some goal, and then after not very long, we realize that, oh, we've totally, you know, gone off track and we're no longer sticking to this goal. So I want to give you three specific strategies that you can use to make sure that you are actually sticking to your goal. So strategy number one is to develop a habit around your goal. And the idea here is that you don't want to have to use your willpower and try and force yourself to accomplish your goal every day. That's basically a recipe for not succeeding, because willpower is not a very strong emotion. And so it's not going to be something that's going to keep you motivated. And so the best way to stay motivated is to develop a habit where you don't actually have to stay motivated at all. Because a habit is just something you do, right? You don't need motivation in the morning to get up and brush your teeth. You just do it because it's a habit. And in the same way with whatever your goal is, I want you to think about how can I develop a habit for this goal? And so the best way to do that, in my opinion, is to start small and build up gradually. So start with 10, 15 minutes a day of work, just very little, just the minimum amount, and then slowly work your way up. So, you know, the first week, try and do 15 minutes a day. If you do that consistently, that's great. Up into 20 minutes a day for the next week. And just slowly build until you get to the place that you want to be. And as long as you focus on doing this consistently, it may take some willpower in the beginning, but if you do it consistently and you start small and build up, you'll be able to develop that habit where you're actually able to stick to your goal in the long term. Next up, don't be afraid to change your goals. This is something that I'm very, very guilty of, where I set a goal and then, you know, circumstances change, the way that I'm looking at the world changes, something happens where this goal is no longer relevant to me. And yet, I still feel obligated. I feel like I set this goal and I need to see it through. And that's a terrible attitude to have, because it's just not productive. Like, I'm basically working towards something that isn't what I want anymore. And so tip number two with sticking to your goals, super, super important. Don't be so set on your goals that you're unwilling to change. If circumstances change, go back and do the goal setting exercise again. Go back and say, like, how do I either change this goal or how do I come up with a new goal? And same with if you're having trouble like sticking to your goal. It's better for you to adjust your goal and make it achievable rather than saying, well, I said this thing and so I have to stick with it. And finally, review your goals on a regular basis. One of the biggest reasons why we fall off on our goals is that we kind of forget about them. And so it's really simple here. One of the easiest techniques you can do is write your goal on a post-it note and like stick it on your computer, right? Just put your goal up somewhere where you're gonna see it on a regular basis, write it in a notebook where you're gonna, you know, go through every day, do something that's gonna allow you to keep coming back. You can even make it your desktop background, right? But just make your goal somewhere where you're gonna see it regularly and you're going to be able to refer back to it. So that's all I got for you today. If you're struggling to think of what a good goal would be for you, I'd highly encourage you to check out our 50 questions guide. What a great goal might be would be to say, I'm going to solve one problem every day for the next 50 days. So I'd highly encourage you to check out the guide. If you have not already, please give us a like and subscribe on this video. If you enjoyed it, please share it with your friends. I really appreciate it. It really helps for the YouTube algorithm. And check out some of these other videos around me. We got a lot of great stuff on the channel and a lot of great stuff coming up. And I look forward to seeing you in the next video.